I am joined by a special guest. His name is Joe Giacolone. He is a former New York City police detective, and he and I had an exchange on Twitter yesterday, and I thought you should hear from him firsthand about weather impacting crime. Hey, Joe, thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning, Bill. How are you?
I'm doing great. So I saw your tweet yesterday about Mother Nature being the best crime stopper, and I had to ask you because, you know, there are two, I'm hearing two different things. On one side, I'm hearing that we're going to have a mild winter. On the other hand, potentially a lot of snow. So what are police departments around the country thinking, and specifically in New Jersey and New York?
Well, I'll tell you, the cops are hoping that there's a lot of snow, because when you have a lot of snow, you tend to have less crime. This is something that cops have always anecdotally said, that the weather predicts crime, and it does. But they've actually done a study. The Department of Justice in 2014 published a report about how the weather does affect crime rates. So, I mean, when you think about it, in the warmer weather, there's more people out on the streets, there's more chance of victimization, and now this is the holiday season. The bad guys know there's a lot of people walking around with a lot of money in their pockets.
Yeah.
So that's a problem.
That's amazing. Because I don't know that you think of it that way, right? So, I mean, and let me ask you this, Joe. I mean, do you see a spike around, like for the, forgetting what we're dealing with this whole threat of terrorism and the soft targets, et cetera, but just around the holiday season, is there a step up that cops go through? Is there some kind of a separate training they do? Is that discussed in the police houses?
Well, it's not so much a training, but like through a roll call that they'll tell you about, be mindful of, especially like in New York City where you have a lot of tourists. But even, you look at Jersey, a lot of the malls, a lot of different things. I mean, last year you had a bad carjacking that happened in one of the malls. So, I mean, bad guys watch people at the malls. They watch you go to the store. They put your stuff in the car, and then you go back to the store to get more stuff, and they're breaking into cars. So, most of the time, these things can be prevented if people take some certain steps before they do it.
Tell me what they ought to do, because everybody's going to be out at the malls, and you're right. You're referencing that horrible shooting at the Short Hills Mall that happened last year. Was that 2 years ago? Was it last year? I think it was last year. Just some horrible, horrible stuff goes on. But what can the average person do? Because there isn't necessarily going to be a police officer on every corner. And, in New Jersey, even if you have a right to carry a firearm, in other states, it doesn't apply here in New Jersey. So you're basically talking about an unarmed shopper that can fall victim to the bad guys. What do you tell people?
Well, the first thing, you have to be aware of your surroundings. I mean, the smartphone now is a real problem for most people, because you got your head buried in anywhere you go. I mean, you try to walk anywhere, in a parking lot, people have their head buried. They're not looking what's going on. And listen, that's what these thieves look for. They look for somebody who is unsuspecting, who's not watching, and 9 times out of 10 won't even be able to give a description because they didn't even see it happen.
Wow.
So, yeah, those are the things you have to be mindful of.
All right, so the first advice is get your head out of the phone as you're walking to your car, because, that, and I watched, there was a video, a guy walking into, or a woman walking into a fountain in a mall. Like, that should have been enough for people to realize, okay, you got to pay at least some attention. But I'll tell you, Joe, I have this issue. I think it's younger people, too. I mean, my son has this capability now of watching TV and also playing a game on his phone.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. I mean, talk about multitasking, right? Let's hope they have a job for that. But
exactly.
Yeah, I mean, that's really something that we have to be mindful of. But, yeah, no, I mean, listen, being aware of your surroundings is always the number one thing about how to keep yourself safe.
All right, now let me ask you, let's talk about terrorism for a minute. There's a lot of controversy going on. Donald Trump making headlines saying that because our government has really failed, in his words, to keep us safe and to even understand what the problem is, there seems to be a disconnect between what's going on in Washington and what's happening in the streets. As a guy locally who's involved and understands and has friends on, forces in New Jersey and in New York, how safe are we? And is there a disconnect from local law enforcement to what's happening at the federal level?
Sure. I mean, I definitely think there's a disconnect, but as police officers, you don't worry about what's happening in politics. You don't worry about what's happening in the White House. You have a job to do. That's what you signed up for. And, as police officers everywhere, they'll tell you that, this terrorism threat is real. It is something that everyone should be concerned about. And, we need to develop better human intelligence here. And that's one of the things I wish the president would have talked about in his State of the Union speech the other day. We have no way of building that human intelligence about what's going on in our communities. Like you saw what happened in San Bernardino. Now we're finding out all these people knew about things and they didn't say anything. So that's the thing that we need to develop. And, you know, listen, cops are going to go out there and do their jobs no matter what. So
now, how about profiling? Is that happen? I'm going to just give you a quick story. So my wife and I went to we went to London for Thanksgiving. My daughter goes to school there. And I'm going to tell you, for the past, I'm going to say 5 years, when my wife and I were flying, she would get pulled out of line. And, you know, she's a tall blonde and getting pulled out of line. And it was interesting to me that it didn't happen this time. And I wonder if that has to do, are they starting to profile?
No, I don't think they're profiling it. The way they usually pick people out is they pick every third person, every fifth person. It has to be non-arbitrary, and it has to be systematic. So,
yeah.
You know, if not, they can, you know, and listen, I don't think anybody wants to play any games with, you know, racial profiling or, you know, ethnic profiling.
You think that's coming, though, Joe? I mean, you hear about what Donald Trump's saying, and they did a survey in the UK. They had almost 300,000 people respond in a positive way that, you know, according to reports we're hearing, somewhere around a quarter of the folks in the UK agree that the problem is something with Muslim immigration.
Well, I mean, listen, what we see some of the politicians or soon-to-be politicians saying is actually quite frightening, too, in certain respects.
Yeah.
But you know what? The public is, I think the public's angry. I think the public is frightened to a degree at certain points because you see what happened in San Bernardino. So we have to make sure that, you know, sometimes cooler heads prevail. From a law enforcement professional view, you have to sometimes let things cool down before you mm-hmm. start doing new items because
yeah.
Listen, overreaction is a bigger problem too. So we have to, you know, find out what the real threat is, how we can go about fighting it, and what we can do to keep the citizens safe, and all those other things. Let the politicians worry about those. But for the time being, at the local level, the cops have to just keep on doing what they're doing.
Yep, I agree. They're doing a great job every day, and sometimes they're underappreciated. Certainly not on this show. Joe Giacolone, New York City Police Department, former detective. Thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. If we don't talk, you have a Merry Christmas, but I'm sure we'll be talking sometime before then. All right, thanks, Joe.
Take care. Bye.